See, let's talk about performance and performance analysis and issues. See, if you want to go out with performance analysis, you have to use a tool called PAL that has been provided by Pegasystems. So these are the different reasons that your performance may go down in your application. First one can be servers might be responding slow, unoptimized DB queries, services must be responding slow, might be responding slow. The process logic what you have written, you might be not managing the memory properly, and the cache management is also one of the issue, and the UI design whatever that you have done might be cause of the issue. They're like loading the list data in one single page may take too long time, where you can go ahead and use pagination and optimize the screen, then performance will be good. And clipboard size is also one of the factor. Too large size for the clipboard also will impact the performance. Time taken from screen to another screen, you have to verify. That might be cause of one of the screen, and using deprecated rules also can be cause of one of the performance issues. Now here, this is a navigation to go to PAL. So you click on configure system performance and performance analyze. Okay, now here, see PRPC is also an application. True. Suppose if you render something within PRPC, suppose you just go ahead and click on configure, click on launch, and click on case worker, something like this, it is going to open a portal. In order to load this user interface here and everything else, it has to take some time, right? Should have to take or not? So let's say, you know, when it has loaded clipboard sizes 100 bytes, for example, and to load this OTP user interface, Pega has taken almost, let's say, 50 seconds, just for example. So the time taken to render the UI and the time taken while you are navigating from one UI page to another page with respect to only PRPC, OTP, can be some time, 50 seconds to load, 50 seconds to move from one screen to another screen. And what is the other one I told you? Size of the clipboard is, let's say, 100 bytes. Now you have designed something by yourself, right? That is what your application functionality is. Now you're going to run something related to your application. You click on this. Now when you perform this action, again, similarly, all these factors will come into picture. Time taken to load the user interface related to your processing that you have designed, plus navigating from one screen to another screen in your processing, plus the size of the clipboard also. Now here the size of the clipboard will be more than what is the size of the clipboard that has been, that we have seen in the previous execution, or it will be less than that. It will be more than that, because by default something OTP loaded that must be there, plus something you are adding on top of it by executing your own functionalities. Now you have to identify all these things. See, throughout your application processing, let's say I have a transaction design, there are 10 screens, for example. Screen 1 to screen 2, if you are navigating, it has taken 5 seconds. Screen 2 to screen 3, you are navigating, it has taken 15 seconds. Because this screen has some services calls, service calls, large data it is loading. Screen 2 to screen 3, you are navigating, it has taken almost 1 minute. Screen 3 to 4, it has taken 10 seconds. 4 to 5, it has taken, again, 20 seconds. 5 to 6, it has taken 15 seconds. All this, whatever you have, 5 seconds, 10, 15, 20, below 25. Does it have any performance issue? When this time is too longer than some ideal values, like 1 minute, does it have performance issue or not? It has performance. Now you need to identify your performance logs every minute. For every action, we have to verify the values. What is the size of the clipboard? What is the time that it is taking from process to process, or request to request, or screen to screen? What are database query time, response time, how many queries executing? This and all, if you see, you need your analytical skills. Pega will not tell you this is ideal value. Ideal values are the values that is the initial execution with respect to PRPC, anything. So whatever that you implement, that is also giving the same ideal values as Pega. That means you have done it 100% perfect, but that is not possible actually. That means you are exactly followed Pega system design and you have implemented it. Definitely we cannot make it 100%. We can make up to 94, 95, 96. Okay, this is clear. So you need to compare these values for every action that you perform. You have to again add one more reading. So by default, when you execute first initial reading and then next one more reading, like this, for every action you have to add readings and compare all these values, downloading into an Excel document. So this you have to compare by yourself. Okay, so that means the values are increasing in the number drastically or not. If so, you have to find out the issue. Okay, just by your own logging mechanism implemented or OTP logging, whatever it is there, you have to find out the issue. For this purpose, Pega provides a tool called Performance Analyzer PAL. And here you go. So when I have initially opened PAL, what is the reading here? You see INIT. So this is initial reading. So the initial reading here, you see 146 initial count, and here you see, I'm sorry, here you go. I'm going to do one thing, add clipboard size here. So this is the reading that will be added with clipboard size. Okay, so the first one you call it as init reading, and the next one they call it as delta readings for the actions that you have performed. See, when I click on this also, it will take some time, right, to load that reading. That will also one of the factor in the performance parameters, but you can ignore that. Okay, some points you can leave it for. So here you go ahead, and let me go ahead and let me open it again for your information. Configure, where is it? Sysadmin performance. I'm sorry, sysadmin, sorry, system, right? System performance PAL. So when you go out here, this is the initial readings that we have. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to run a flow, begin insurance. To load the user interface here, it has to take some time, right? Now one action is completed. Once this action is completed, this is OTP in PRPC, or this has been done by me. So up to execution for that invocation and all OTP, and remaining part, the display of rendering of this UI, which I have created, apart from OTP, something user defined is there. Now here you go ahead and see, after you complete this action, click on add reading with clipboard size. Once you do this, what happens? It will add another reading. Now you see here the initial reading 175, and here you see 191. The difference between 175 and 191, what is that? 13. This is what interaction count, INT count here is called interaction count. The interaction count is 13. Like this, you just go ahead here and then click on submit. One screen is completed, it went to next screen, let's say. And once you are done with this, come back here and click on add reading with clipboard size. What is the interaction count now? 14. For screen one, interaction count is 13. For screen two, interaction count is 14. Does it have drastical change? No, it doesn't have. Suppose for screen two itself alone, the interaction count difference that you see here is giving us 200. Then means there is some issue. Okay, now. Means more number of interactions are happening, might be unnecessary interactions are happening. That might not be Pega interactions, that might be interactions that you have created. Okay, and number of rules you are calling unnecessarily. You have to optimize your coding the way you have coded. Now you see here, clipboard size. The size of the clipboard here by number of bytes. Here, for this it has taken, by default Pega has taken almost 7,000. So for you it is, it's not 7,000, it is more than that. Just for ease of understanding, let's say 7. Now the bytes is 1 and here 0.6. It is not too much increase in the bytes. Anytime while you are performing number of different actions, if you see the clipboard size in bytes is drastically increasing, then you have to think about only that step and then proceed to analyze that. Why the size of the clipboard is increased? During when I am performing this action, am I not properly removing the pages on the clipboard in my coding? This and all you have to verify. This is clear? Now, see, you click on any one of the delta reading. I'll upload this video. WhatsApp ping, I'm sorry. See, okay, let it get loaded. See here you can see the elapsed time here, whatever the value that you can see, and the CPU time, and here you go. This is important. Run execution counts and request summary. See the time the requester when he has started, you will be able to know the time of PAL reading which has been started and the number of server interactions that are happening, 191, and here the number of input bytes that is being received from the that is received by the server, means how much data that you are sending. See, you look at this for multiple interactions. You click on delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, multiple deltas you will be adding, right? For one of the delta, you see that this number is drastically increasing, means you are sending a lot of data to the server, might be which is not required. And the number of output bytes that is being sent by the server, you are receiving for all the places you are receiving, let's say 100 bytes, but one of the places you see 1000 bytes are being received. Might be you are sending a wrong input, or maybe production data is used and you are receiving large data sets. So this is how you have to compare with the previous actions that is being performed, and you have to identify the issues accordingly only at that particular step. And the requested clipboard size in bytes, every time it is with less difference the number is happening, that is okay. But if you see huge difference anytime, then you have to think about it and remove the clipboard bias accordingly. Your code should be optimized. Like this, you need to analyze the PAL readings, and you have to go ahead and understand the PAL readings in comparison with first delta reading with init readings, next delta reading with previous reading, next delta reading with previous to previous everything. So like this, your analysis should proceed. Okay, and for this unit, if you do practice this for some days, you'll come to know. So this one, if you want to export it into Excel, you can go ahead and click on save data, then it will be exported into Excel file. So here you can see the number of interactions, activities count, the total number of commits that has been happened, total number of activities that have been executed. Sometime you see there are number of activities 10,000 is being executed. Maybe one activity might be called again and again, some infinite loop like that. So it will count each time how many times this activity has been executed. Then you have to look at it. So count of connections, how many connections are there? The number of connections that drastically increasing. Suppose you are calling a database, one connection, again you are calling again and again, this is happening without your knowledge. Okay, there is some place. So counts will increase. Count of DB exceeded the threshold and all it will be giving, and the number of declarative rules that are executed. Might be inside declarative rule, without your knowledge, you have done something which is regularly calling the other declarative rules, chain process, something like this may cause some of the issues, but that will not happen generally. So like this, there are different parameters here that you need to identify and understand, and then proceed forward to analyze your performance of the application each step compared to all previous steps. This is clear. For this, you need to take some time, and you do once, twice, thrice, you will come to know. So this comparison should not only happen with today actions, last release, previous release also you should have the documents. Suppose one of the actions that you are performing today, you find the issue, open the document related to last release, and then see for this action, step two, what is the reading that I have been noted previously. So you compare, oh, okay, it has been drastically increased, might be some code which I have developed now is causing the issues. Okay, this is clear, everyone. So suppose everything is same, but still you see slowness issue, means it might be some time, long time it is taking. It might be the issue with third party tools that you are, vendors or something like that. This is only analysis, it's not the solution. Analyze to understand the performance issues can be done by using performance analysis. This is clear. I'll upload this video. You can wind up for today. Thank you for joining. I'll send you one of the documents which I have downloaded from PDM. Every column is not required actually.